Dear students, assalamu alaikum. How are you? Hope you will be fine and safe. Welcome to the pre-9th class of Pakistan Studies, the chapter number 1 and the lecture number 3. This topic is from your textbook, Punjab textbook, and from the page number 4 to 8. Today the topic of our lecture is the basis of the ideology of Pakistan. The Muslims of the subcontinent got a separate homeland so that they might give practical shape to the final and absolute authority of Almighty Allah. The people might implement the absolute power of Almighty Allah, and such a system might be practiced as was based upon the principle of the Holy Quran and the teaching of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam. The ideology of Pakistan is based upon Islamic ideology. Islamic values such as the belief and prayers. Number 2 is justice and equality. Number 3 is promotion of democracy. 4th one is fraternity and brotherhood, and the 5th one is right and duties of citizenship. Dear students, now one by one we will describe it very briefly. First one is belief and prayers. The first point is very considerable in belief and prayers, which one is Iman. Iman means that the belief of Islam include belief in the oneness of God, Tawheed, the finality of the Prophet of Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, life hereafter angel, and the book revealed by Almighty Allah. This set of the above mentioned belief is called the Iman. And the second one is the first pillar of Islam, Tawheed. It means that to believe in the oneness of Allah and the finality of the Prophet of Hazrat Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the first pillar of Islam. Oneness of God, Tawheed, means that Allah is the creator and master of the entire universe. No one is his partner and nothing is beyond his knowledge. The third one, which is very important, that faith in prophethood. Faith in prophethood means that to believe that Allah sent messenger for the guidance of mankind. It is compulsory for a Muslim to have a staunch belief in prophethood without having any kind of doubt. This demand that the Holy Quran and the noble life of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa sallam must be acknowledged as the source of guidance. The second pillar of Islam is Namaz. Namaz is the obligatory to offer play at the fixed hour. In fact, to be steadfast in prayers is similar to be steadfast in religion, and it is demonstrated every day. The third pillar of Islam is the keeping fast, and the fourth pillar of Islam is Zakat. It is a monitoring prayer. And the fifth pillar of Islam is Hajj. It is an obligation only for those who are financially able to perform it. Now, the second heading is, which is the base of the ideology, that is justice and equality. Justice and equality means, dear students, it is on your textbook number 6. It is from your textbook number from 6, and this topic starts from the page number 4 to 8. Justice and equality mean, while establishing a just society, the Muslims put an emphasis on justice. It is determined in Islamic belief that all human beings are to be given equal status without any discrimination of caste, color, creed, language, and culture. In Khutbah Hijjatul Wida, Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam explained this fact in the following word: O people, all of you have one God, and all mankind is the offspring of Adam. An Arab has no superiority over a non-Arab, nor a non-Arab has any superiority over an Arab. Also, a white has no superiority over black, nor a black has any superiority over white. The next one is promotion of democracy. First one is, it's very important to know what does democracy is. It is a form of government in which the common people hold political power and can rule either directly or through elected. Consultation and deliberation are the basis of the Islamic state and society. Democracy is promoted in an Islamic state and the rights of the people are protected. Every citizen enjoys equal status. People live their lives observing and respecting the law of the land. Laws provide security to the people. On 4th February 1948, Qaid Azam said in the following words, "Let us lay the foundation of our democracy on the basis of the truly Islamic principles. Our Almighty taught us that our decision in this affair of the state shall be guided by discussion and consultations." The fourth one is fraternity and brotherhood. Fraternity and brotherhood means fraternity and brotherhood are two synonymous terms, means fellowship, companionship, group of people sharing same interest. Fraternity teaches to develop brotherly relation with one another so that neither right of anyone are usurped nor the weak is oppressed by anyone. The Holy Prophet said that each Muslim is brother to every other Muslims. He should not commit breach of trust. He taught to refrain from maliciousness, malignance and enviousness. Therefore, he must live united. They should help each other. The last one is, which is very considerable point of the basis of the ideology, is right and duties of citizen. When Pakistan appeared on the map of the world, the significance of the right of the citizen was acknowledged. At that time, much emphasis was laid on the duties of the citizen. In an Islamic state, right and duties are closely connected, both go hand in hand. A person does his duties, deserve to enjoy rights. Mutual balance between right and duties is the key to make an Islamic state. And Qaid Azam addressed that about the security of the minority. He said, the right of the minorities must be protected in Pakistan. He said that Islam does not allow that life, property, dignity and religious tradition of the minorities in Pakistan go unprotected. Dear students, at the end of the topic, I would like to suggest you that read the page number 4 to 8 from your Punjab textbook of Pakistan study very carefully. Keep in your mind, this topic is from 4 to 8, page number 4 to 8. And this topic is the answer of the first long question, evaluate the Islamic values that are the basis of the ideology of Pakistan, and then learn and write this question. Okay, you have to write, first learn, then write on your notebooks. And at the last, I will memorize that the basis of Pakistan is based on Islamic ideology. Islamic values such as belief of worship, justice, promotion of democracy, fraternity and the duties of the citizen are the basis of the ideology of Pakistan. I hope, dear students, you well know about this basis of the ideology of Pakistan. Thank you so much. Allah Hafiz.